We were traveling for like 5 or 6 hours. Just at one point, someone appears in the middle of our path. A young guy wearing a hat with a poopy in the hat and an AK-47. No? And he said, I think you are the journalist, right? So just follow me. My name is Alfons Rodriguez. I'm from Barcelona. I'm a documentary photographer, a filmmaker. This rebel group, it's belonging to more than 40 rebel groups that are hiding in the jungle of Congo. They want a piece of land to extract minerals. This is a wild land. This is a land with no laws. We were for like 8 months preparing and trying to get this place. In the middle of the jungle, we reached a village. We were waiting for like 3-4 hours to the general, the commander of the rebel group. Suddenly he appears in the door with a smile and he said, hey, how are you guys? And he sit in front of us and we give mango juice. We have some bottles of mango juice. When he opened the bottle of mango juice, he offered to one of the of this child, you know, and said, just taste it. And then he looked at us again and said, maybe you are going to poison me, so. These two guys are 12 years old. They became child soldiers. They were recruited by this rebel group because their parents were killed. Really, these two guys that changed my point of view about to tell stories. They wanted to escape, but they can't. I took this photo when they were making a kind of training. They were shooting with guns, but in order not to expend bullets, they were like doing an onomatopoeia with the mouths, like da-da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da-da. And it was like a play for them. I was thinking, these two guys have killed people. There are many child soldiers, like 50,000 right now. They lost their parents, so they don't have nothing. We have to hope that most of these guys can escape this terrible life. North Korea is the last frontier of our world. North Korea is a surrealistic place. I didn't feel in danger when I was there. When you enter the country, the authorities put a kind of military police. Everything is forbidden for you as a foreigner. You cannot take pictures of almost anything. It was not easy to get into this country. I really used a trick. For that, I was telling to the authorities that my mission was like make a kind of researching to develop tourism in the country. This is Pamunyan, the village Pamunyan near the frontier with South Korea. And it's the place where took place the armistice between North Korea and South Korea after the Korean War in the 50s. You can see the uniform is really different to the South Korean soldiers, which is more in the line of the USA. They are pretty tall, pretty strong guys. In North Korea, they are just like a small and very tiny guys. This is the place where North and South Korea signed the armistice. After my trip to there, it was like enter in another world, in another planet, in another galaxy. But I have the chance of take some kind of forbidden pictures. I remember that was absolutely forbidden to take pictures of countryside or people working on the countryside with animals, with tools like excavating the land, like scraping something. It's supposed that they are right now in the technological revolution, no? So you cannot show how the people is still working like in the Middle Ages. We didn't know nothing about Siberia. Nobody knows nothing about Siberia. The winter, as you know, Siberia is at 20, 30 below zero, 4 to 5 months per year. They have a very big problem of alcohol and drugs. Young people is living in a very hard conditions. They have no work, no future possibilities. This is the way to escape, no? This is the way to try to improve their feelings. There are a lot of people dying and losing their families, houses, and their works, their jobs due to drugs. We were accompanying a medical team, and one of the emergencies was a call coming from a mall. we take the ambulance, we start riding through the highways, and we finally reach one small city with a very big mall. When we reached the toilet, it was a very small and dirty toilet. Inside, there was this young girl. And at the beginning, we thought that it was dead. It was an overdose of some kind of drugs, I suppose it was heroin. But finally, she recovers. But this reflects a very big problem in Russia, especially in Siberia. It's very simple and very easy to live with our eyes closed. But the world has two faces, two ways to understand the world, no? The beauty of the world and also the dark face of the human kin. This is what I try to do usually.